The idea of eliminating waste comes from the Toyota production system. Taishi Ono, who is considered one of the founding fathers of lean manufacturing, dedicated his career, most of his career, to establishing an efficient work process. Based on his observations and deep analysis, he categorized 7 wastes, which later became common practice in terms of cost reduction, in terms of optimizing resources. And this is exactly what we're going to talk about in this video. I'm going to cover the 7 wastes of lean, probably the wastes of lean, with real life examples so that you can start eliminating wastes in your team, processes, organizations, even in your personal life right now, today, by the end of this video. The first waste is waiting. Any process that stops project activity, basically a work delay. Some common examples of this waste are approval delays or delays because of dependencies. Let's look at the first example. Approval delays is a huge bottleneck. So someone needs to do a job, but before doing this job, another person needs to approve it. Oh, just finish the job. I need to send it to another person so that someone else can do it. Huge bottleneck in the chain of a project if this approval process takes time. And often this is exactly what happens. It can take hours, days, even weeks to approve something. And the quick fix for this is to move to a more instantaneous approval system. So instead of going through emails or even through the system, which takes long, just send a chat to someone. Just lift up your phone and talk to the person. Verbal communication. We are in 2021. We should start trusting people. We don't need to put everything through an email. Another example of a waiting waste is dependencies. Waiting for an environment to be ready to start the development of a software. Waiting for an interface and API to be available to start development. And a quick way to fix it is to plan better. Really plan better and make sure that every team involved, all the dependencies involved, follow the plan, what they committed on. The next waste is transportation, which involves moving people, inventory, tools, and other items further than required, more often than required. And this causes maybe damages in inventory, in tools, and unnecessary work. Some common real life examples you see is moving maybe hospital patients from one department to another, moving inventory across states further than required or more often than required. I work a lot with teams in the banking industry. I coached a lot of teams in the banking industry. And one common problem I see extremely often, you'll be surprised about this, is having a staff working for a company facing the customer, maybe taking loan applications, and this person needs to sign, the customer needs to sign a piece of paper. So the staff needs to print this piece of paper, needs to click on a button to print the paper on his laptop, on her laptop, and then move to another floor. Take the stairs, take the lift to another floor where the printer is located. Take the piece of paper, print it now, move back, come back to the customer and make the customer sign it and place this paper on another floor again so that someone else can process it. The next waste is motion. And a good example in software development of this waste is context switching. Context switching happens everywhere. Even right now, maybe you want to click out of this video. You can't focus. People can't focus now. And when in software development, when someone is not working on a single project, working on multiple projects at the same time to meet priorities, requirements, it's a complete waste of this person's time because this person can't focus. You know how the brain works. The brain takes around 10 minutes, 15 minutes to really get in the flow, to really focus on something. 10 minutes, 15 minutes to get in the flow and focus on something. And if you get disturbed every 20 minutes, you get a call, you get a chat, someone talks to you, you can't work. You can't work because you'll need another 15 minutes to get back through what you were doing previously. And then you get disturbed again and you take another 15 minutes and it goes on and on. A lot of research has been done on this topic and it's recommended that a person focuses on a single project at a time. When you add another project, 20% of a person's time wasted. If you add a third project, 50% of the time of a person wasted, completely wasted because of this context switching. And a good way to fix that is to add a work in progress limit to prevent someone from working on multiple things, because we know developers, we even not developers, many people, they like to work on multiple things at the same time. It's human nature. So add a work in progress limit. Try to limit the task or stories or anything that someone is working on to the minimum, so that the person can focus on that and can complete it and move on to the next task. The next waste is inventory waste. And a good example of this is partially completed work, like a piece of code in software development. Not completed, you wrote it, half of it. And not completed, you move on to something else. And this piece of code is just lying around, taking inventory space. And it's not only partial code, it can be undocumented code, untested code, undeployed code. And a good way to fix that is really a shift in mindset. Not only software developers, nope, everyone else also involved in the team. Everyone involved in the team, we should have a shift in mindset of we should stop starting and start completing, start getting things done. Stop working on multiple things at the same time. Take one thing, get it complete, and move on to the next. Stop starting things when things are currently being worked on and start finishing. Start getting things done. The next waste is overproduction, producing more than the customer is willing to pay for, which results in additional costs. And a good example of this are features in applications, which are completely useless. No one asks for these features. No customers are using these features. And we took months to develop these features, because someone in middle management or upper management just believed that this was a good feature. No research was done whatsoever. We didn't survey the customer. We're not working with the customer. We're working for this person in middle and upper management. Complete waste. And this happens extremely often in big organizations. And a good example of this is Samsung. I don't know if you remember, but in the Galaxy S4, there was a feature called the air gesture, basically swiping using your hand or something like that. And I can't really remember what the feature did, but no one used it. And it's not even in the latest Samsung phones. And there's a reason for that. It's because the feature was completely useless. They thought, they advertised it. It was in the demo, in the trailer of a phone. Everyone was hyped. And when the feature came, we realized that it was just good looking on paper and maybe in a video, but you used it one time and you no longer used it. So how many hours were spent developing and researching this feature? God knows. But it's a complete waste, and that's exactly what overproduction is. The next waste is overprocessing, basically doing work that brings no additional value or brings too much in terms of value, more value than required. And a good example of this is documentation, spending hours, days, weeks documenting something that no one will ever read when we could have just picked up the phone and talked verbally or through chat instead of spending so many hours documenting something. And the final one, the final waste is defects, spending people, time, material, producing something of poor quality and then spending additional time fixing it or trashing it. And in software development, that's basically defective code. Maybe the software developer lacked the skills required to develop a particular feature. Maybe the software developer didn't understand the user story, the requirements, the acceptance criteria. There was no agreement for the definition of done. Testers were involved too late in the process. They weren't able to test. They lacked the skills to test. So many reasons, which brings me to my next point. If you want more tips, insights on Agile, Scrum, personal growth, click on the video that stands out the most on the screen right now. And I'll see you in a few seconds.